I know that you started out Coleman here in Birmingham. How do you feel tonight about essentially your hometown being at the center of the culinary universe?
Very happy, thrilled. We've just arrived home and just can't wait to share with our staff. Lots of high fives and hugs, and I know we have a lot of guests who will be coming in this evening and who are going to be really excited to share this with us, who I think also take ownership in our restaurant and what we do.
And that's so much of the spirit of the place, is that this is not about me, Pardos. It's about this whole family of a restaurant, and it's about our regulars that come every Tuesday evening to have a beer or a great cocktail or a wonderful glass of wine and maybe some oysters and sit at the bar, and then they to kind of gather with your friends. And so Highlands has always been that spot that where people of Birmingham would come to gather and maybe even perhaps like you to celebrate events. But we've never ever wanted to be a fancy restaurant. We never wanted to be an overly serious. We want to strive for the greatest quality and excellence and graciousness and service. And we want to be smart about everything that has to do with food and wine. But you know, it's just, it's kind of like the home team has won. It's like, you know, Alabama or Auburn has kind of won the national championship.
It's wonderful, and it is. I grew up in New York. That's a place that seems to win all the time, and Chicago, yeah, and San Francisco, and New Orleans. Everybody knows those places. Here you are, two locals. You started on a wing and a prayer, I'm going to guess, like so many restaurateurs in 1982, and here you are now. I know enough about you to know this is a very humbling experience for you. Does it make you feel any different about this particular Tuesday or going forward? Artist was saying, pressure's on now.
Well, you know, it's one of those things that, you know, I had almost resigned myself that this would never happen, that, you know, the numbers, the demographics, the number of people that eat in major urban centers versus Birmingham. And so I was like, okay, it's just mighty fine to be nominated. But it's so exciting, and it's so wonderful for all of us, you know, and all the families of people that are involved with people that are here. And so it's a big network, and it's just been overwhelming, the response of so many people. People that worked with us 20 years ago are calling and congratulating.
They're calling and texting and emailing, and so we're feeling a whole lot of love right now.
Well, I think you probably should. Anything special on the menu tonight for celebration? Maybe a little champagne will pop somewhere along the line, or just sparkling water?
Well, I think there's going to be some champagne in the Highlands future for tonight. But it's, you know, we are actually not able to craft a new menu in 30 minutes. And so we're pretty much running with our Saturday night game plan. But it's always special. And we always try to have the greatest ingredients. But it's going to be, I anticipate, a gathering of a lot of the people that, you know, really care about this as just part of Birmingham.
And to people who say, this is great, but I can't generally afford a place like this, why does it matter to folks in Central Alabama that this place really has put Birmingham on the map? And I do know, I should add, that you have been very active in trying to do the restaurant weeks, and I think you've got something going on tonight.
That's
at
right.
Park.
That's right.
So, but maybe speak to that a little bit for people who think, well, this is sort of not my story. This is sort of out of reach.
You know, I mean, like I said, we don't believe that we are out of people's reach. I mean, we are basically the almost the same prices, maybe a couple of dollars more, of major chain restaurants that people go to all over America. And so I think we're even a better value when you think about it. I mean, it's not like $100 caviar, and I mean, no, you can get the best shucked oysters on the half shell for the same price as any place. I mean, and so there is a little bit of a mistaken impression that it is exclusive or it's too expensive or all of that. And we've tried to create a place that is really more inclusive than exclusive.
Thank you so much, both of you. Are there plans to do something to expand or to, I'm sure you get asked this question all the time, there are not enough seats a lot of nights. You're probably tempted to bust down a few walls down the street or whatever, really create a monster of a venue. Thought about that?
I don't know about a monster of a menu. I think, you know, we're both really creative, and so we're always, you know, we're always, if we see a space and we just get really excited and think, oh my gosh, that could be an amazing oyster bar, or that could be an incredible wine bar, or that could be an incredible whatever. And we would work very hard to, you know, to make it something really special for Birmingham and for ourselves. But I don't think that we are in a place right now where we want to expand
or go to New York or Los Angeles.
No. You know, with the Highlands and Bottega three blocks away and Chez Fonfon right next door, you know, our places are within just a couple of minutes. And so we think it's really important that Partis and I are here, you know, every day. And so we don't want to do a place that far away. That just doesn't make sense for us. To me, there is a real special sense that comes from creating an energy in a place. And you can't be an absentee person to do that.